Hello friends, welcome to my channel. So today I am going to work on my next topic of JavaScript, which is JavaScript OOP, means Object Oriented Programming. So in this tutorial, you will see how you can create class in JavaScript, how you can create objects of class in JavaScript, how you can create constructor, and how you can create method inside class, how you can use static keyword in class, and how you can create a static function inside class, and also how you can use inheritance. So let's get started and work on this tutorial. So first, back to VS Code. And let's create a new file. So js class and object oop.html. Enter. Now let's create a js file also. So again, click on new file, js oop class and object dot JS. Copy it, click enter. Now let's come to this page and simply adding a HTML. So after that, JavaScript class and objects. Let's add a script src js object, close the script tag. Now save it, also adding a heading h1 JavaScript OOP tutorial with example. Now save this page also and come to this page and console dot log JavaScript OOP tutorial. Now save it. Now let's run this page. So click on terminal, new terminal, then ./ js class and object, enter, and you can see this page is running. Click on inspect, open console, and you can see my JS page is running and HTML page is ready. Now let's start our tutorial of JavaScript class and object. So first let's see how you can create a class in JavaScript. So let's see, come to VS Code, close it. After that, let's create a class in JavaScript. So creating class in JavaScript. So you can create a class simply by starting keyword class. After that, you need to pass the class name. So here, let's suppose that I am passing the class name like, let's see, I want to create a class name like product items and parenthesis. So my class is ready. You can create an object of this class by simply, let's see, create object of class. So simply where, then variable name like variable one equal to new, then pass the class name. So product items semicolon. So you can also see the syntax where variable name. Now here, after variable name equal to new class name. Now let's simply print this variable. So console dot log variable one, save it, back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see it's showing empty data with objects. if you open this proto, you can see it's showing class product item. So in this way you can create a class in JavaScript. But now let's see some usage of this class. So again back to VS Code, and let's suppose that I want to add some variables or some properties. So here I want to add like ID, then name. Also remember this, you don't need to add where here, it will not work. So simply you need to add a property name here. You can see it's simply ID, name, and here also like image, and also adding like ID, name, image, price. Now save it, and if I check this again variable, you can see what it will come. So back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see this time it is showing some data which is showing undefined. You can see all the properties of this class are showing undefined because we didn't set any value. So if I want to set some value, like you can see, come here and let's see, set property value. So simply like variable 1 dot id equal to 1 and name equal to Samsung Galaxy, and image equal to, let's copy some image. So back to Chrome, let's copy the image. So here let's copy some image. So copy this simple image and back to VS Code and paste it. Now let's see next field or properties name. Next is price. So let's set price like 1000. So save it and back to Chrome and come to this page and refresh page, and you can see all the values are set in this class. And here it is showing image, so it should be image. Now save it, back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see all the item of class are showing now. So in this way you can create a class, and you can create an object, and you can set the value in object. Also remember this class is just a blueprint of our code or some data. Now if you want to access value of this field, so simply get property value, so console dot log name, then variable 1 dot name. Save it, back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see it is showing the value of properties of class. So in this way you can set the value, you can access the value of class. So this is simple. Now also if you want to create multiple object of class, you can create it. So like see here it is first object, like second object of class, paste it, and this time change this to variable 2. Let's select it. So selecting all the variable 1, change this to 2, variable 2. Also change this to Samsung Note, and price 2000, ID 2. Save it, back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see you can create a new object which is Samsung Note, and it is showing the value. So you can use class to create multiple objects which are different from each other. You can see if I see here, this will not affect in this class, and again if I create object, it will not affect in this class. So each data had different value and different properties and different method. So in this way you can create a class, create a object, and access value and set value. Now let's see next example, which is constructor. So let's see how you can create a constructor. So here currently if you see, I am setting the value using setting property. You can see object dot property and set the value. But there is also another way for setting the value using constructor. So what is constructor? So constructor is the first method which is called when we create a class. So suppose that if I create a constructor console.log call first after creating object. So constructor is a first method which is called by default when we create object or class. Now save it and back to Chrome and let's see what actually happened if I create this constructor. So back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see here first it will print call first creating object. So our constructor code is calling first, then after that it calls the object of data, which is printing the data of object. So remember, this constructor is a method which is called by default when you create a object of class. So in simple word, constructor is a special function which is called when you create an object of a class. Here if you see, I create this constructor and it will call immediately, then it will call this code. So first it will call this constructor code, then after that it will call this method. Now let's see how you can set data or set property using constructor. So let's see, setting property value using constructor, then here id, name, image, price. Now here if I set like id equal to id, name equal to name, and image equal to image, and price equal to price. So let's see what actually happened if I create this like. So let's see, create another object, creating next object with constructor. So where variable 3 equal to new product item, and you can see it is asking for parameter. So this is the example of constructor. When you create a constructor, it will call this method. You can see this parenthesis is used for calling the constructor. Now here we need to pass the value which can be accessed by constructor here. So whatever we pass the data here, it will be accessed by constructor here. So suppose that I am passing like price id 3, after that you can see it is asking for name, so like Nokia, then it is asking for image, so let's see the image, come to Chrome, copy the URL, back to VS Code, paste image, after that it is asking for price, so let's see 3000 and save it. Now let's check what actually happened if I print it. So console.log variable 3, save it, back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see everything is showing undefined. But here if you see, I am passing all the value, then why it is showing undefined? Because we are setting the value in same variable. If you see, id is same as id, so there is nothing happened. So how we can set this data from constructor? So we need to use a special keyword which is this. So this is keyword for accessing current class properties. So let's see, you can use this dot id, this dot name, this dot image, this dot price. Now save it back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see this time it is working. So this is the importance of this, and this is the importance of constructor to create a object with some properties data when you create a constructor. So in this way you can create a constructor with some parameter and set this data in class properties. So the simple example, you can see first I show how you can set the value, later I show how you can pass the data or properties in constructor. Now let's see next example, which is how you can create a method in class. So let's see, suppose that I want to create a method. So here let's create a method, get product full details. So here just return name, after that this dot name id, this dot id price, this dot price. Now save it and let's check it's working or not. So currently if you see, I created a simple method in class. Now we are going to call this method. So again here if you see, I created a variable 3. So let's see, where full details equal to variable 3 dot get product full details. So simply call it again console dot log full details, save it back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see you can access the full details of product. You can also call this method in other objects like here console.log variable 2.get product full details, save it back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see you can access the product full details. So in this way you can create a method in class. So currently I saw the example of how you can return the value from class. Also if you want to use another method like setting the data or update the data, so let's see, update product name. So suppose that I want to change the product name, like new name, this dot name equal to name. So in this way you can update the data of class, save it, let's check it's working or not. So suppose that here I am passing Nokia, but I want to update the data. So variable 3 dot update product name, and want to change it to OnePlus, save it back to Chrome, refresh page, and here if you see it is showing Nokia, but let's see, okay, here it is full details, but if I change this to, let's see here, print it again, console dot log variable 3. So currently it's not get updated. So currently if you see, I update here, but I didn't print here. So let's see after update, back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see this time data is changed to OnePlus. So in this way you can create a class, you can create a object, you can create a constructor, you can create a method inside class, and also you can use method for update the property of class. So this is very simple example of class and object in JavaScript, and class and object is a new feature which come in JavaScript ES6 version, which is very popular, and you have to learn this topic because it is very useful when you are working with React.js. Now let's see next example. So again, now let's see how you can create a static function and what is the advantage of static function. So currently, if you see, you can't call this method directly. If I try to call like product item, let's see console.log product item.get get product details. So let's see what actually happened if I call this method directly. So back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see is not a function, so it will not work. So you can't access the function or method directly from class, but if your method is static, you can access the value or you can access the function. So let's see creating example of static function. So let's see, I am going to create a one more class like class app and static init console.log app is initialize, save it. Now here if you see, I added a keyword static. So now we don't need to declare an object or create an object of this class app. You can call it directly. Here let's see console.log app.init or app.init. Save it, back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see app is initialized. So in this way you can create a static function and it will work without any object. Currently if you see, I didn't create an object like this. Here I create variable 3 object because we are using static function or static method. So we can call the static method directly without calling a object reference. So let's add a comment. A static method can be called directly without creating objects. So save it. Also, if you think what is the usage of this static function, I will show how you can use this static function in a simple program which you understand better what is the importance and what is the advantage of using static function. Also let's see one more thing. If I create object, so let's see app equal to new app console.log log app and save it, back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see app is showing empty. If I try to call the method, let's see what happened. App.init. So save it, back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see you can't call this function from object. So remember this, when you create a static function, it is only called by that class. You can't call the static function by creating objects. So also adding comment, you can't call the static function by creating a object. So comment this, save it. Now everything is working. Now let's see next example, which is how you can use inheritance in JavaScript OOP, means how you can create a base child class. So let's see how you can create this simple base child class. So again, back to VS Code, and here suppose that I have this class product item which is parent class, but I want to add some more thing, like if you see the mobile device which contains specification RAM, but in same product item if you see other item like LED, so it contains size and other thing. So in this case both are product, but they have different properties, like TV contain size, LED support, or is smart TV or not, but in phone it contain RAM, processor. So these are the extra features in both products. So in that case, you can create a parent child class. So here, suppose that I create a product, but now let's create a child product. So let's see how you can create a child product using inheritance. Using inheritance. So simply here, let's create inheritance child class of product items, then class after that, like mobiles, extends, and here pass the parent class name. So our parent class is product item, so simply pass here product items. After that, here if you see, it is a child class and it will work for its parent class. So let's leave it empty now because I made it child class. But let's see, if I change this to here, change this to mobile, and let's see it is working or not. So save it, back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see still it's working. But here if you see the properties or object, you can see it is showing mobiles and it is showing product items. So both are same, but it just a child class. So let's see, I am going to add some method in product items and also adding some properties like size, RAM, storage, and same again creating one more class. So copy this and paste it. This time change this to LED, and this time it contains size but is smart TV, and also change this to weight. Now save it, and here first I create object for mobile, second I create object for product item, third I create object for mobile. Now let's create one more object. So let's see. So again copy the object, so simply copy it, or let's create an object. So let's suppose that I am creating a variable LED obj equal to new LED, then let's pass the value in constructor. So first ID let's pass 5, name like MI smart TV. After that image, so simply pass the same image, copy it and paste it. Now next is price, so make it 2000 or 5000, and let's print it console.log LED object. Save it, back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see here this time it create a LED object with its property and values. So here if you see, first I create object for mobile, second I create object for LED. So both are class of product item, but it is a child class of product item. If you see the parent class, let's open this and open this photo, you can see it is showing product item. So our product item is a main class and mobile is a child class. Again if you see this, it is showing product item which is main class and LED is a child item. But here one more thing you have to see, currently it's showing size undefined, weight undefined, because we didn't pass this data. If you see this in mobile, same thing. So what is the issue? Let's see. Currently if you see, we are passing the data only to class, but it will work only for same data which exists in previously in product item. But here if you see, I add some more field, so this data are not setting. So in that case, you need to override the default constructor, which is called constructor overriding. So let's see. Constructor overriding. So simply constructor, or just do one more thing. So simply constructor, then we need to access the value. So previously it contained all the data. So just copy this constructor, copy it and paste it here. After that, we need to add some extra parameter for this. So size, RAM, storage, and here we need to override the method. So super, pass the ID, after that name, image and price. After the remaining, so super method will pass all the data to our parent class. So if you see super method, it is calling the parent constructor, means it will call this method and pass all the data in parent constructor. After the remaining data, size, RAM and storage, we need to set here. So this dot RAM equal to RAM, again multiple time, copy, size and storage, and also storage, save it. And now let's see, save it, and here we do changes in mobile. So here mobile, like let's create one more object, or let's see, first back to Chrome, refresh page, and here if you see it is showing. But now let's create a object for mobile. So back to VS Code, and again where mobile obj equal to new mobiles. This time constructor is asking for different argument. You can see it is showing ID, name, image, price, size, RAM, storage, or everything. So let's pass the data. 6, name is like MI, then image, so just copy this image, copy it image and paste it. Now next parameter is price, so make it 6000, then size 7 inch, then RAM, make it 4 GB. After that storage, so make it 64 GB. Now let's print console.log mobile object, save it, back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see all the data are set in the our mobile object. You can see it's showing ID, image, name, price, size. So in this way you can create a constructor overriding method. You can see I create a constructor overriding, and also pass the data which is coming from constructor to our parent constructor. So that's why I call the super method, because it will call the parent constructor method and pass the data in parent constructor. If I don't call this, let's see what happened. Save it, back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see it is showing error, must call super constructor is drive class. So that's why we need to on the super method. It will pass the data in our parent constructor of our class. So it is working. So in this way you can create a constructor. Now let's see one more thing, method overriding. So let's see how you can create a method overriding. So currently if you see, it's showing product details, but if you want to change this method, so again copy this method and here paste it. But in this method currently if you see, it is returning everything like name, price or ID. But here in mobile condition, we need to return different data. So let's see how you can do this. So again, simply override the method, then pass the data like name, this dot name, then here RAM. So currently if you see previous, it is not returning the RAM data, but here I am going to return the RAM size. So this dot RAM, and also return the storage. So this dot storage, and save it. Now back to Chrome, refresh page, and here if you see, okay, I will not call this method, so just call this method. So here after this mobile object dot get product full details and console dot log, save it, back to Chrome, refresh page, and you can see it returning the data of our mobile. You can see it return the data of mobile. So in this way you can create a method overwriting in JavaScript class and object, and override the default method. You can see in current product, in product details I am returning only name, ID and price, but if you see in mobile details we need to return this RAM, storage and size. So that's why I need to override the method and return the RAM, name and everything. So in this way you can create a constructor overriding, method overriding base child class. So it is working. Now let's add comment, method overriding. Now in next tutorial I will show you how you can make a shopping cart using JavaScript class and object. So I hope you like the video. Thanks for watching. Please like our video and subscribe our channel.